Well, good morning, everybody. It's David George Brook, that gratitude guy with the daily gratitude news for July 31st, 2020, last day of the month. And of course, reporting every day on how gratitude impacts you in so many different ways. And today, a couple of interesting things. Your hypothalamus works better. Gratitude does something quite peculiar into the brain's system. It activates the hypothalamus, not one of the most glamorous parts of the brain, but a seriously important one. The hypothalamus is responsible for regulating all kinds of bodily functions, including hunger, sleep, body temperature, metabolism, and how the body grows. It's one of the body's control centers, and gratitude seems to motivate it to excel. Interesting. A 2009 series of studies using MRIs of brains showed that the limbic system in general, of which the hypothalamus is a part, is activated whenever we feel gratitude, pride, or do something altruistic for somebody else. That means gratitude actually makes our metabolism, hunger, and other natural bodily functions work more smoothly. Why? I don't know why, but it's true. You're more resistant to stress. Stress is a huge thing in this day and age, as we know. Resilience is more than just a quality in a video game. In psychology and neurology, it is a term that refers to the body and the brain's ability to bounce back from seriously stressful events like trauma, homelessness, grief, or job loss. And it looks like gratitude helps us become more resilient and less vulnerable to continued stress throughout our lives. They had collected studies that showed that people who are grateful recover more quickly from horribly stressful stuff. It seems to be a seriously useful coping strategy, a good thing to remember if you're dealing with something tough, another great aspect of gratitude. And finally, today, you fall asleep more easily. Given the effects of gratitude on the hypothalamus, it's not entirely surprising that the gratitude-filled brain might find it easier to slip into normal, natural sleep than one that is not feeling thankful. It's been shown to help people with chronic pain too. A study of adults suffering from serious neuromuscular disorders found that the gratitude exercises made them sleep more and wake feeling more refreshed. And you don't have to be suffering from an illness or anything else to benefit from that. So again, a number of great things that gratitude can do for you. And so that's the news for today. And we'll see you on Monday with the next edition of the Daily Gratitude News. I'm the Gratitude Guy. Remember, be grateful and never quit.